Brandon Guyton, and Charles Davis.
Larry, we haven't had NFL football in this city for 22 years, but football is back here in Los Angeles. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the New York Jets and the Los Angeles Rams. On first down, Goff. And the catch made by Kenny Britt. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game going early.
And they did, and what a warning shot they just fired. If you're not going to back up and play coverage deep, we're going to attack you all game long. And once you adjust to that and you start to back off, then that opens things up underneath. A really nice start for them. Great way to get the game going.
Now let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Goff on first down. And they'll set up the screen to Gurley. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. Second down now after the pass completion.
Set! Blue 90! Blue 90!
On second down, here's Goff. He finds Kenny Britt. And an alley to run. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
All right, now, lucky 56. Over, over, over. Back. 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 Philly, here we go.
Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. That one good for 10 yards, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. And the defense with their backs against the wall
Leopard,
a little bit here as
Leopard.
The offense is in the red
no,
zone.
No, check. Patriot! Patriot! Here we go now.
All right, now. All right, now.
Patriot now. Barney! Barney! Hurry up. Here we go. Detroit! Detroit!
The throw on second down is gone. And he can't corral it. Maybe a big missed opportunity there defensively in the end zone. And now third down.
Detroit! Over, over,
the wide receivers
over,
often a very, very talented group, and that's the case here.
And they don't mind showcasing it either. Those guys love to be flashy, love to make big plays out in the open field. They will attempt to do so in this game.
Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one.
Leopard! Leopard!
No, 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 no. Check. Patriot!
Hurry up, Patriot!
Now Goff on first down. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a second down. As we get a look at the defensive starters, the secondary, they're certainly going to need to be on their toes in this one.
And you know me really well. Where do I start analyzing a game? From the secondary. And these guys have to be on point today. They're facing a high-powered attack.
Detroit! All right, here we go. 3-19!
Here's Goff now on second down. This will be caught at about the 6. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. And this will be play number
Detroit,
8 of the
Detroit.
Opening drive. It's third and short.
Detroit!
Let's go!
Detroit!
Now, Barney! Barney!
All right, here we go.
Goff on third down. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. Picked off by Marcus Gilchrist. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, there definitely was some juice on that pass. And while tight ends don't always have the same reputation for hands as wide receivers do, in this case, that ball was expected to be caught.
And now out come the Jets.
Now let's go!
From deep in their own territory, they look to throw. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
So second and 10 here.
Go nowhere, 22, go nowhere. Hurry up, here we go.
And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Let's get off the field, D. We got right. Back 99 Philly. Here we go. All right, here we go.
Here's Patty. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. The starters on defense here for Los Angeles.
Aaron Donald's dimensions were talked about big time when he first entered the league. Many called him undersized. Now they just call him all-pro.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
Now let's go. Boo, 90. Boo, 90.
Let him know.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Petty now.
Run.
And that is incomplete. Here's Lachlan Edwards now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone. And he'll try and hurry the kick, gets it away, but it's not looking that great. Here's Austin. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position as they take over. Really nice starting field position
check,
here for
right,
the offensive
right,
unit.
Right. Solo out there, check the outs out there. No.
Goff turns and gives to Gurley. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine. Second down following the run. They come out here in the eye.
All right, here we go. Boom!
Another carry now for Gurley. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a third and eight situation. Well, Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and eight.
Set, move, land it.
Throwing on third, gone. He's going to find his man. That's Tavon Austin. That one good for 15 and a first. Back live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, and they've got it here with a first down. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
It's up, it's good, and the Rams take a 7-0 lead. After the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. Marshall now, the return. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Here's the Jet offense. Now they head out to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Hurry up, here we go.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And this is caught. First catch by Brandon Marshall. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. So second down, 3 yards to
watch
go now.
Watch 81. Let's go, D. Nick Sears right here.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
He'll drop to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Three yards left to grab here on third down.
All right, here we go. Green, 39! Green, 39!
They'll look to throw here. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
And it's not the punting unit. It's the offense that will stay on the field and try to pick up the first down. He'll look to throw. And Marshall's got it. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's Patty. And his throw is incomplete. Again, they were targeting Marshall there, and it's second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They come out five wide, three of them to the... Yeah, the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. Unable to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down.
Now let's go! 3-19! Over, over, over!
That's into the morning!
Green, 39!
Petty now. Finding time. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone, open, unable to hold on to it.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, 6 DBs. And now another one thrown incomplete.
But no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the pump ball was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
And with the play clock winding down, we're going to get a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on four.
Leopard! Leopard!
Here we go.
He'll try and throw for it here. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the Rams get the football in outstanding field position. Scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. See if they stay on the ground for a second down. Time running out here on the play clock. Again, they run with Gurley. Not much there. Maybe a couple as he's taken down at the 40. A bunch of Jets there. A whole gang of them flying to the football to make the stop. The line to gain is the 33 on third down.
Tight right, tight right. Detroit! Detroit! Let's go!
Throwing on third. Goff completes it right side to Britt. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, it came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to the City of Angels after this timeout. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13.
Here we go.
On second down, here's Goff. That is caught at the 7. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate.
All right, now, lucky 56. All right, here we go.
On first and goal, Gurley. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. They come out here in the eye.
Blue 90.
On the keeper, here's Goff. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
Hey, give him credit. That's a good solid gain there on the sneak because it all comes together. Enough space, get forward, gain yardage. Well done.
Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. So a defensive brain lapse there and an encroachment penalty.
Sometimes when you don't watch the football and make sure that it's snapped, you're watching the offensive player, and they can influence you occasionally and look like they're getting ready to move, and the officials don't detect it.
No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
Well, I think the effort was there, but sometimes the defense is just a little bit better. No gain on the quarterback sneak, no place to go.
So on fourth down, Goff will yield to Greg Zuerlein for the field goal try. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. It's a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they get the field goal near the end of the first half to expand that lead.
Now that's got to feel good, but they can't let up. Now on the kickoff, they've got to make sure they don't give up a big return or big yardage to set up the other team for one last chance to score themselves.
After the made field goal, Zuerlein back out there now to send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. Now the Jets offense gets ready to head back on the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And with time running short here, they'll simply take a knee, and that should do it for half number one. Time for a break. We've hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The New York set to take the field. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Here we go now. 3-19.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Watch it now, Barney! Barney! Let's go!
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. And he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. So he makes the grab, and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
And the offense lining up first and 10.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
Hurry up. Here we go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Second down following the run.
Now let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Call it a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here. 3rd and a yard. Now 3rd down, less than a yard. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Now back to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
I'm not sure we can spot any tendency here on this 3rd down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
The decision for Todd Bowles, and he says, let's go for it on 4th down.
Set, blue, landing.
Needing the tough yards, they run into their fullback. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. 5 yards on the pickup, and on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks. So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs.
Here we go now.
Another run, this time for Tay. And he'll be taken down at the 34. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. Set up to throw. And he's got Decker, left side. And he'll go down at the 28. It'll be a gain of six, and they'll be faced with a third and inches. So third and inches, and this will be the ninth play of the drive.
Here we go now, Forte, the lone running back.
Watch the screen.
Petty now. And he finds Safarian Jenkins. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They go back to the ground attack here. It's Forte. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets them up now first and goal. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Here's Patty. He rifles one that's intercepted. And he's into the clear. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return will stop right around the 25. Out come the Rams. They'll have it first here to begin the third quarter. And they had 3 points last.